Hello and welcome back to the Confident Parenting Podcast, or if you're watching on YouTube, to my YouTube channel. Sorry that I sound like a man. I was a little under the weather, had a bit of a cold, nothing serious, I was fine. And then I went to the Taylor Swift concert, which, if you know, you know, it's the happiest place on earth. Anyway, I flew to Miami, I went to the Taylor Swift concert. I just got back 2 days ago, and now, even though I feel a lot better, my throat's not sore, I sound like this. So I hope you guys don't click away because of my gravelly voice, because this video today I think is important for a lot of people, and it's not the most sexy topic, but I think it's a very important one, and that is how to stay and become more organized. I've been reflecting on this a lot because this is something that I do daily to keep my house maintained, and I don't want to only talk about my method of organization, which I will get to. I want to talk about why it is so important to have an organized life. I just notice in myself when things are not organized, how I just can't do very much because I'm almost paralyzed by the overwhelm of things being in chaos. I see it in other people as well. Like, I can tell when people feel overwhelmed, they make mistakes, they drop the ball on things, and then they internalize that shame and blame. And it's all because they just didn't have simple systems in place. They didn't have good habits in place. And some of that can just start from the basics of your home and keeping your home organized. And if we consider that our home is our base, you know, I spoke about this in a previous episode about my home being like my fourth child, like something that needs attention, it needs maintenance, needs to be cared for, not dissimilar from a human child. I mean, not the same. I know my home is not the same as my kids, but it's a similar concept where every day you need to pay it attention. And I think we just let that go a lot of the time, and then it becomes so overwhelming. So we are in the middle of remodeling our house. We've kind of been through stages of, we'll do a project and then it stops, and it seems to just take forever. Let me just tell you that. Especially when you're living it day to day. And it just really alerts me to the fact that when my house is in chaos, I just feel so unhinged. You know, I just feel untethered to anything. And because I work from home, I spend a lot of time at home. I have 3 small children, so we're homey based, even though we do lots of stuff. It's very important that our house feels like a sanctuary for us. And by that, it just needs to be clean and tidy and organized. When I have stuff everywhere, I feel super stressed out, and maybe you do too. I've also been noticing I've taken a different strategy this sort of term at school, semesters, this school year, where we're doing a lot more activities than we have ever before. And with 3 children, it's just a lot. So I don't think I could do that if my house wasn't organized, if things weren't in a certain spot where I could where I knew where everything was, where I didn't get things lost, where I could just get my keys or get the school uniform or do the things, sports, clothes, whatever, and come home, and my house doesn't take hours and hours to reset. So that's a little bit about why. And I would love to hear in the comments, in your words, if you feel like having an organized home is important to you. Do you prioritize that? If so, why not? Obviously, people like to live in sort of creative chaos, and that's a little bit different. But just having systems in place to help your life tick over, especially as a busy mom, but just as a busy person in general, I would be like this anyway, even without children. Just children add an extra layer of stress. I'd be curious to hear your opinions on it and how it's helped you or hinders you, and what your thoughts are. What's your relationship with the word organization? Do you hear that and you're like freak out, or do you feel like, oh, I want to be organized, I'm aiming for that? So here's the thing, and I'm rushing a little bit, I don't mean to do that, but I have to go and pick up my kids very soon. If you need to start being organized, and if you need to maintain organization, there's just a few things you got to do. And I was doing this morning. I want to just walk you through my method briefly. So I went to go and see Taylor Swift. So I flew to Miami. I got back late Saturday night. They're renovating our kitchen. It's kind of a mess. The floor feels like you're walking on chalk. And I'm sorry, I just cannot. I know it's almost like, it's like making your bed. You're just going to mess it up that night anyway. The same with the floor and builders. They're just going to mess it up. Like, now they've been working today. Today's Monday. And then work yesterday because it was Sunday. And the floor is like, feels the same again under my feet. I want to be able to walk around my house without my shoes on. You know what I mean? But I took, even though I came back from this flight, I vacuumed on like Saturday night. I unpacked my suitcase basically immediately, did some laundry, and just sort of started to reset my life again, even though it had only been away for 2 days. And because we're renovating, my husband had two of our kids. I had the third one. And it was just kind of a nightmare. Like, luckily I wasn't there because I would have gone insane. But we didn't really have access to our kitchen for those few days. Anyway, so fast forward to Monday morning now. My kids are at school. And I just took probably like 25 minutes, maybe less than half an hour to reset our house. And the way I personally do it is I do it in layers. So the first thing that I do is I take everything that's not in a specific room and I allocate it back to that room. That would be your first layer. And even if you're unpacking a house from a move or you're organizing for the first time, the very first step is to put things in their room. Like, it doesn't have to be put away perfectly. We're not aiming for perfection. We want functionality and we want you to be able to find where things go. So I basically systematically went through each room. I went through the kitchen. I went through the dining area. I went through each child's bedroom. I had done a load of laundry, so I had to put away each of their laundry at the same time. I kind of reset each of their rooms and I just took my time to reset each child's room, which is quick because I really try and keep their rooms sort of minimal, decluttered. I'm trying to be mindful about what I buy them. If you're curious about that, I just released a video all about my relationship with gifting and what I'm choosing to do, consumerism as far as my children are concerned, and like the holidays coming up and everything. But by doing that, it made it really simple to be able to put everything back. Everything has a place. And I just repeated this method over and over again, which is like, gather everything that doesn't belong in that room, put it into the space that it belongs to, and once that is done, go back and just put everything properly back. I think that's also where people really fall short, is they think it's going to take hours to put away laundry, so they just don't do it. So then it builds up, and then you have a literal mountain of laundry, and you never ever get around to putting it back because it's so overwhelming for your brain. But if you just did one load of laundry every day from start to finish, aka washing it, drying it, folding it, and putting it away, you would have virtually no laundry and it would not be an issue in your life. And it becomes so habitual. Take it from someone who's now done it. I've like integrated it into my life. We do a load of laundry every day, sometimes two loads of laundry. I have three children, so maybe that's not going to be the same for you. But we don't let the laundry pile up to where it's unmanageable. If I do that sometimes, like I'll skip a day, I regret it every time because then I have to fold this massive mountain of laundry and I don't want to do that. So just psychologically, doing a little bit every day, like breaking up a 4-hour organization process into 30 minutes every day of the week is so much more manageable and so much more pleasant. It's like you're cultivating your home. It's almost like if your home was a plant and you were watering it and tending to it, it's that version of that. We're not doing anything crazy. We're just maintaining. We're keeping up the organization. And this is the way that I keep my home organized with three children, with a husband that travels a lot, with like a busy, busy life, with a full calendar. But I prioritize keeping our home orderly. And it's not perfect. My children come and they'll go use things and get our toys and play, and that's fine. But it can all be put back fairly quickly. They can put it back as well when they know where things go. So much easier for them to put things back. So I just want to encourage you, if you're in the process of like decluttering and organizing, and I'll do a separate video about decluttering because I haven't done one in a while, but I do have a lot of videos on my channel about decluttering and organizing. I think today I should keep it short because I do sound a little rough and I do need to run. But I don't want you to feel overwhelmed. Put on this podcast video, whatever it is to you. Listen to it for motivation while you go around your home and just tackle one space at a time. Tackle your desk, tackle a drawer, tackle a cupboard. You know, it doesn't tackle the bathroom cabinet. It doesn't have to be anything groundbreaking. But over time, it all adds up and you'll get back to the beginning of the house again and like just refresh it. It's just really important. Alongside with like renovating our kitchen, we had to remove all of the things out of a lot of the cabinets. And it just gave me this ability to put everything back, to clean things, to declutter certain things. It was like the greatest feeling ever. And my husband was like, I know you love this. I know you love this. I don't love not having a kitchen. I will say that. It was terrible. And we're going to go back. We have to get some things painted. So it's going to happen again for even longer. But I did love putting everything back and like reevaluating whether I needed something and where it should go. And does this even make sense? And can we sell this or should we donate this? Like, It was awesome. Anyway, I have to run, but please consider subscribing if you found this video helpful. Give this a like. I'm going to do a video all about decluttering. Let me know what other videos you'd like me to do, and I will see you very soon. Bye.